Hello everyone, I am Priyanka Shah and welcome to my YouTube channel Mathelite. In this video, we are going to continue with the second exercise of rational and irrational numbers. Moving on to the second question. Find the square of, you are given few numbers over here. We need to square them and find the answer. So, the first one number is 3 root 5 by 5. I need to square it. Now 3 square into root 5 square upon 5 square. 3 ka square is 9. Root 5 ka square, square of a root of a number, the number itself. 5 ka square is 25. 5 5s are 25. So I have the answer 9 by 5. Moving on to the second number. It's an identity because I'll get root 3 plus root 2 the whole square. This is of the form a plus b the whole square, which is a square plus 2ab plus b square. So a square, that is root 3 square plus 2 into a into b, so that is 2 into root 3 into root 2 plus root 2 square. Square of a root of a number, the number itself. 2 square root into square root, so square root common ho jayega. 3 into 2, so that is 6. Plus square of a root of a number, so it will be the number itself. 3 plus 2 gives 5 plus 2 root 6. Again, you are not going to add the 2 root 6 to 5 and make it 7 root 6. So please keep that in mind. Isko hum log isse add nahi kar sakte. So the answer is 5 plus 2 root 6. And over here I got 9 by 5. Moving on to the third number, root 5 minus 2. The whole square. Now this is of the form a minus b the whole square. A minus b the whole square on expansion gives a square minus 2ab plus b square. So it is going to be root 5 square minus 2ab, so minus 2 into root 5 into 2. So root 5 into 2 plus b square, so plus 2 square, which gives square of a root of a number, so it, the number will remain as it is, minus 2 into root 5 is going to give me 2 root 5 only. So 2 root 5 into 2, that is 4 root 5. I multiply the numbers and root will remain as it is because there is no other root over here. So outer numbers mein multiply karungi, root wala as it is hi rahega. Plus 2 ka square, that is 4. Again I'll add only these numbers, I cannot add this number. So 9 minus 4 root 5. So this is my final answer. Moving on to the fourth number. 3 plus 2 root 5. The whole square. Again, this is of the form a plus b the whole square, which is a square. That is 3 square plus 2ab. That is 2 into 3 into 2 root 5 plus 2 root 5 the whole square. Now, please be careful over here. 3 ka square 9 hoga. 2 into 3, 6 into 2, that is 12 root 5. Root will remain as it is and over here I'll multiply these numbers. So 2 into 3 into 2, so that is 12 root 5. You're not going to multiply root 5 with this. Okay, so please be careful. 2 ka square plus root 5 ka square. So 2 ka square is going to give you 4. and square of a root of a number, that is the number itself. So it is going to be 9 plus 12 root 5 plus 20, which is 20 plus 9, that is 29, plus 12 root 5. I hope you all are clear with this question. Starting with the third question, state in each case whether true or false. Over here, you are not asked for reasons, so you don't need to mention reasons. First one, root 2 plus root 3 is equal to root 5. Now, main root 2 ka value nikalu and root 3 ka value nikalu, and if I add them, I'm not going to get it equal to root 5 ka value. So, it is a wrong statement. Root 2 and root 3 is not equal to root 5. For that matter, root of any number and root of any number, main unko directly add nahi kar sakti hun. Even if the numbers are equal, say if I have root of 7 and root of 7, it is not going to be equal to root of 14. Okay, it is not going to be equal, it is completely wrong. Even if they are unequal numbers, hum log koi bhi number ko aise directly add nahi kar sakte hai when they are in the root form. So, the statement is false. Coming to the second part, 2 root 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. Over here, we need to verify. So, LHS ka value calculate karna padega, whether it is equal to 6 or not. So, 2 root 4 plus 2. 2 into root 4 is 2 plus 2. 2 2's are 4 plus 2. Yes, it is equal to 6. So, LHS is equal to RHS. Therefore, the given statement is true. Now, third one, 3 root 7 minus 2 root 7 is equal to root 7. 3 root 7 minus 2 root 7. Over here, I have root 7 common. So, root 7 ko main common le leti hun. And in the bracket, I'll have 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. So, 1 root 7 is basically root 7. So, yes, 3 root 7 minus 2 root 7 is equal to root 7. Therefore, the statement is true. Moving on to the fourth question, 2 by 7 is an irrational number. Now, 2 by 7 is of the form P by Q, jahan pe dono integers hai and denominator is not equal to 0. So, it is a rational number. It is not an irrational number. So, the statement is false. 5 by 11. 5 by 11 is of the form P by Q, where both are integers and Q is not equal to 0. So, yes, it is a rational number. Therefore, the statement is true. Coming to the sixth question, all rational numbers are real numbers. Now, real numbers, say R, is a set which consists of all the rational numbers and irrational numbers. So, all the rational numbers belong to the set of real numbers. Therefore, I can say all the rational numbers are real numbers. So, yes, all rational numbers are real numbers and the statement is true. All real numbers are rational numbers. Now, all real numbers cannot be rational numbers because some real numbers are also irrational numbers. So, the statement is false. Some real numbers are rational numbers. Yes, some real numbers are rational numbers and some real numbers are irrational numbers. Therefore, the statement is true. And with this, we are done with the question number 3. Let us begin with question number 4. You are given a universal set over here, and from the given set you have to find the set of rational numbers, set of irrational numbers, set of integers and set of non-negative integers. So we'll begin with set of rational numbers first. Set of rational numbers is denoted by capital letter Q. Now, first number, minus 6. It is an integer, and yes, all integers are rational numbers. So minus 6 is a rational number. Over here I have a mixed fraction. Now let us solve it. 4 5s are 20, 20 plus 3 gives 23, so answer is going to be minus 23 by 4, and it is a rational number because it is satisfying the criteria of being a rational number. Minus square root of 4. Square root of 4 is 2, so the answer is going to be minus 2. So minus 2 is an integer, and yes, it belongs to the set of rational numbers. Minus 3 by 5 and minus 3 by 8, again they are fractions and they belong to the set of rational numbers. 0 we know is a rational number. 4 by 5 again is a fraction and it belongs to the set of rational numbers. 1 belongs to the set of rational numbers. Now, mixed fraction, on solving it I get 3 1s are 3 plus 2, 5 by 3. So, it is belonging to the set of rational numbers. Now, square root of 8. Square root of 8, if I factorize, it gives 2 into 2 into 2. So, here I'll get 2 root 2. Iska square root ho jayega 2. And this will remain as it is. Now, 2 root 2 is an irrational number. I am having a root 2 over here, which is an irrational number. So, square root of 8 is an irrational number. So, it does not belong to this set. 3.01. 3.01 is a terminating decimal and it belongs to the set of rational numbers. Pi does not belong to the set of rational numbers. It is an irrational number. 8.47 again is a terminating decimal and it belongs to the set of rational numbers. Now moving on to the set of irrational numbers. Now set of irrational numbers is denoted by Q prime. Now whichever numbers are remaining which do not belong to the set of rational numbers are irrational numbers. So square root of 8 and pi are irrational numbers. Set of integers, that is z. Now integers, minus 6 is an integer. Here it is a fraction, so fractions are not integers. Minus square root of 4, it gives you minus 2. Minus 2 is an integer. Over here I have fractions. Fractions are not integers. 0 is an integer. 4 by 5 is again a fraction, not an integer. 1 is an integer. Over here again I have fraction. Here I have irrational numbers and terminating decimals. So they do not belong to the set of integers. Now, non-negative integers. Ab ye mere integers hai, usme se non-negative kaun sa hai? These two are negative. So, these two are non-negative. So, z prime is going to be 0 and 1. And we are done with question number 4.